Hey, I'm Tim Sander, and I'm here at Microsoft Ready in Seattle. Today, I'm going to talk a little bit to you about partitioning in Azure Cosmos DB. So today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about partitioning in Azure Cosmos DB. So I've drawn a little diagram here of a Cosmos container, in other words, a collection in Cosmos DB. And it's a collection that has three different physical partitions. So first part of our talk together, we're going to talk about how partitioning works, really go deep behind the scenes and all that technical details. And then at the end of the session, we'll take a step back and talk about what you, as a developer, need to know in order to partition your data effectively in Cosmos DB. So here again, we have a container in Cosmos DB, and we have three different physical partitions. We've provisioned 3,000 RUs on your container in Cosmos DB. So Cosmos DB achieves its scaling magic essentially through partitioning, and we're able to do that by when you scale up this amount of RUs by basically adding on partitions as needed to accommodate that number. So I'll give you a little insight into how that works. In this case, we have 3,000 RUs. So that means each partition, each individual physical partition here, gets 1,000 RUs. This is basically an individual piece of physical hardware that's in our data center. And when you provision throughput on your container, we automatically take that amount of RUs that you provision and divide it up among all of the physical partitions that you have. If you, let's say, were to raise this number and go from 3,000 to 5,000, we would increase the amount of throughput assigned to each physical partition. This is all handled for you automatically by Cosmos DB. Now, in many cases, you might need to scale this up by a very significant number. Let's say you might want to scale it up from 3,000 all the way up to 36,000. Now, each one of these individual physical partitions can have up to 10,000 RUs allocated to it. So in this specific example, three physical partitions would not be enough partitions. That wouldn't be a high enough number of partitions to accommodate 36,000 RUs. So what Cosmos DB does behind the scenes, with absolutely no impact to your production workload, it all happens automatically, is we split one of the existing physical partitions and then create another one. That has a subset of the split partitions data. So in this case, if we had 1,000 RUs in the previous example before we scaled up, now we have four partitions, so we have 9,000. RUs on each physical partition in that example. This all happens behind the scenes automatically. You as the developer using the product actually really never need to understand how this works, but it's great that you're watching this video because this is an engineering area in the product that we're really quite proud of because there's no limit to the amount of partitions that you can have. You can add on as many physical partitions as you'd like, and our biggest customers have hundreds, thousands of these, and it really scales quite well. The next thing I want to shift to is what you as the developer using Cosmos DB need to know and what you're going to control and really need to understand effectively to use the product. Now, you as the developer using Cosmos DB are going to specify this value here, PK, which is basically my abbreviation for partition key. Your partition key is going to dictate where your data is stored among each of these physical partitions. Now, each of these physical partitions, as you saw before, is a subset of the resources. And it also has a subset of the data allocated to it. So the data on this physical partition does not overlap at all with the data on this physical partition. The partition key that you set is going to decide basically what data is stored where. Cosmos DB is going to store one or more partition keys on the same physical partition. Your partition key is basically just a property in your document that you designate to be the deciding factor in how your data is stored. So if, for example, I'm at a conference now, let's imagine I have a Cosmos DB container that has data of attendees at this Microsoft conference. Attendees could have names. They could have ages. And they might have, let's say, social security numbers, SSN. So a unique identifier per person, right? For example, we could use this unique identifier as the partition key for each person. So we'll just rename it PK to keep this diagram nice and clean. Based on this PK value in the document, we're going to basically decide what person what document basically is stored on which physical partition. We make the guarantee that all the data within a single partition key is going to be stored on the same physical partition. So when splits like this happen, like you saw earlier, we'll split an existing physical partition, but we will not split an existing logical partition. Cosmos DB, in order to work well, needs to guarantee that all that data remains on the same individual partition key. Each of these big guys here, each of these big physical partitions, can scale up to, as I mentioned earlier, 10,000 RUs or 10 gigabytes of data. That also means then, because each partition key cannot be split across physical partitions, each individual partition key can scale up to 10,000 RUs or 10 gigabytes of data. So now that's a nice transition into the second part of our little conversation together. What are the best practices of picking this partition key that you want, as a developer using Cosmos DB, really, really want to be aware of? Now, the first one that you probably were guessing if you were really following along closely was cardinality, right? Each of these partition keys can only grow to 10 GB and it can only grow to 10,000 RUs. So obviously, if it has a high cardinality, if there's many possible values for this partition key, there's essentially no limit for how much you can scale out in Azure Cosmos DB. So best practice in almost every case, when you create a container and pick your partition key, it has to have a really, really high cardinality, because this is essentially your only scaling bottleneck in Cosmos DB. You can create as many partition keys and as many partitions as you'd like. So that's always key for any workload. It's also very, very important that this partition key, this guy here, does an excellent job at evenly distributing your reads and writes and also storage. You saw earlier that we basically allocate throughput across your physical partitions, and each one has a subset of the data and a subset of your throughput, a subset of your RUs. So if all of your requests went to this physical partition here, we would be able to consume up to 9,000 RUs, but we wouldn't be able to borrow. We wouldn't be able to borrow from the physical partition next door. So this individual partition key can consume 9,000 RUs on this physical partition, and all of these partition keys together could consume up to 9,000 RUs, but they can't borrow from the partition next to it. So because of that, it's very, very important, very, very, very good if your partition key does a good job at evenly distributing requests and your RU consumption, right? Because that ensures you're able to saturate all your RUs available. Obviously, the next extension of that is important for it to balance storage as well, because if it balances the amount of data stored per partition key, it's naturally also going to evenly distribute requests most likely as well. Those two things typically tend to correlate strongly, not always, but in most cases. Very, very important that your partition key satisfies those three properties: high cardinality, evenly distribute requests, and evenly distribute storage. That's important for any workload on Azure Cosmos DB. Now, for some workloads that are very read heavy, there's a fourth property of a good partition key that I like to add. If you run a query in Cosmos DB on this database and this collection that has data about different people, the conference attendees, with name, age, and PK, if I ran a query that filtered on, let's say, age, right now age is not the partition key of this container, right? If I wanted to run a query that filtered on age, what I would need to do is separately and independently check each partition's index. When you run a query in Cosmos DB that needs to check each partition, we're basically going to run one query per partition that checks the index of that partition independently of the others. So we'll do this in parallel. It'll be quite fast, but it's not as efficient as if you maybe partitioned the container in such a way that the query knew which partition all the data it needed was on. So if you have a query and you can maybe partition on the filter of that query, if you have a query that you run very, very often and you can partition on a property that's in that query's filter, and it's an equality filter, you can have the query actually go only be routed to the relevant partition, and that's going to make the query's RU charge much lower. Not relevant for all scenarios, but for really read-heavy scenarios, that's a fourth optimization that we like to throw in there that can be very helpful. In addition to that, partition keys are the logical boundary for stored procedures in Cosmos DB. And that's also something, if you're using stored procedures, to keep in mind as well. That's it. That's partitioning. I hope this gave you some insights into how it works behind the scenes, and also some key takeaways for what you, as the developer, the architect, the DBA that's using Cosmos DB, needs to know about partitioning in order to be successful. Thanks again.